Valentine's Day coming. What's the color of Valentine's Day? Of course, it is red, just like a tomato. You know, at one time, tomatoes were called love apples. Indeed, in French, they still say pomme d'amour. Sounds better in French, right? Well, where does this idea come from? From an ancient notion that any substance that resembled the body or a part of the body would have an effect on that part. Well, on Valentine's Day, of course, we talk about love and we talk about aphrodisiacs, named after Aphrodite, the Greek goddess of love and passion. And the belief was that tomatoes resembled the human heart. I guess if you stretch your imagination a little bit, they do. And that's why they were thought to have an effect on the heart. Well, over the years, numerous substances were put into the category of being aphrodisiacs, that is, specific stimulants of the sex drive. Why? Because of their resemblance to parts of the human body. For example, the orchid. The roots of the orchid look like the male testes, and that's why orchids have been prized as a gift of lovers. Well, talking about that particular part of the anatomy, believe it or not, the Aztecs used the same word for avocado as they did for the human testes. And obviously, because of resemblance, they had this aphrodisiac quality. Mostly foods that resemble parts of the body were put into this category of aphrodisiacs. And you can imagine why the asparagus fell into that category as well. Although I think, to be honest, I think the uncooked asparagus would do a better job. Many, many other substances were reputed to be aphrodisiacs. The horn of the rhinoceros. Well, the horn of the rhinoceros obviously has a phallic shape, but it is only made of keratin, same stuff that our hair and our nails are made of. So the chance of having some sort of aphrodisiac effect from chewing on the horn of a rhinoceros is the same as the effect of chewing on your nails. Essentially, no effect whatsoever. The roots of the ginseng plant resemble the human body, so therefore was supposed to have an aphrodisiac effect. Of course, all of this is really in the mind. If you think something has a stimulant effect, it just may. However, on Valentine's Day, obviously, we do have to talk about chocolates, because those are the classic gift of lovers. And there's a story here as well. And the story is that chocolates contain a compound called phenylethylamine, which is supposed to boost your amorous thoughts. Well, it sounds very good. Unfortunately, there isn't any real science to it. Phenylethylamine doesn't really have that effect. And in any case, it is found in many, many other foods other than just chocolate. For example, sauerkraut is rich in phenylethylamine. But let's face it, showing up on your lover's doorstep with a jar of sauerkraut is not nearly as seductive as showing up with some chocolate. Of course, as I said, red is really the color of Valentine's Day. Why? Because blood is red, heart is red, etc. So if you don't want to give your lover a gift of chocolates or of sauerkraut, you might want to just give them a nice rose. Happy Valentine's Day!